Hey everybody, it's John Bay, Sean Hillacre from Standard Uranium. Here we are up at our Sundog project near Uranium City. Now many of you are probably wondering, why Sundog, why Uranium City? We've heard about that in the past. Maybe you could give us some background to some of our newer audience, Sean, as to what happened at Uranium City? Why is it called Uranium City?
Well, it's aptly named, John. It was actually Canada's very first uranium mining camp. Yep. And produced a lot of uranium through the late 50s, 60s, 70s. And it's kind of been shut down since then. There's been a bit of exploration in the area. The Sundog project hasn't been touched in about 14 years. Mm-hmm. So we're really excited to, you know, come kind of breathe some new life into this area, to do some modern exploration up here. And you know, we're not the only ones. There's some other great companies doing some work up here in the area too.
Yeah, exactly. Now, back to our shareholders, we had a question from Lauren in Lexington. She wanted to know, are we looking for the same type of deposits that they had here in Uranium City or something different?
Actually, it's different. So, you know, there's obviously uranium everywhere up here, which is great for us. Yep. but the Uranium City deposits that have been mined in the past were actually a lot smaller, a lot lower grade. And they're what we call Beaver Lodge style deposits.
Yep.
So geologically speaking, it's just a different terrain. So different rock types, that kind of thing. We are actually up here looking for that high grade Athabasca style uranium. So that unconformity related uranium deposits. So up here we have Athabasca sandstone. Our project sits right along the northwestern edge of the Athabasca Basin. So we're actually exploring through that thin cover of sandstone because we're right on the edge.
Yes.
And we have uranium right at surface. And what we're looking for is, you know, high grade roots in the basement, but that stuff is still close to surface too. So from a production or mineability standpoint, that's great news too.
Awesome. Thank you very much and hope that answers your question, Lauren. Once again, keep those questions coming, everyone. It's Sean Hillacre and John Bay from Standing Uranium saying goodbye from the Sundog Project.